Good afternoon, children. How are you all? Hope you are all fine. In the previous lesson, we have discussed the poem that is, What is Player? We learned who the true player is and also the difference between the player and a true player. And also we came to know the qualities of a true player in the previous session that we have discussed. Now today, dear children, you all know that after completing the reading session, we have the task that the discourse construction. That in every reading, either it is a reading or B reading or C reading, after completing any reading session, that we will go for the discourse construction. You all know that you are very much aware of the discourses. As we have major discourses and minor discourses. But as we have completed the poem, What is Player? Basically, we need to construct the choreography. The discourse is choreography. But the thing is here, we have some change. In the previous poem that you learned the decade, the kangaroo, the choreography. But now, for our poem, now we will have the other one, other discourse. Dear children, you know what is discourse? The discourse is the communication of thoughts by words, talk, conversation. These are the discourses play vital role. So that discourse means simply that we use for the communication. So the discourses, basically, if you see that the history of discourses, the discourse has various definitions. But one way of thinking about it is any piece of extended language, that is either it is in written or spoken, that has unity in a meaning and purpose. So if you see that the term discourse, a discourse is a term used to explain the transfer of information from one person to another. So this is, why shall we learn the discourse? Because whatever the message we wanted to convert, whatever the message we wanted to talk with others, that we need to construct the discourse. So it helps the use of words and sentences. That means it is we use to communicate, especially the discourse is used to communicate. Either it is in the form of words or sentences. So this is, it happens either orally, the discourse can be, it is either orally or written through the spoken language or in a written format. So after reading, we have been learning the discourses, discourse construction. So that today we also learn the important one is, as we have the major discourses, interview, storytelling, narrative, conversation, and all these, we would like to construct now today, we learn about report writing, report or news reporting. Now this is the discourse that we would like to go, we would like to learn. Dear children, that I will tell you the parameters, the indicators of the discourse, then you understand the discourse, report or news report parameters, performance indicators, and after understanding this, definitely we will be able to construct a discourse very easily. That everything, if you wanted to construct a discourse, basically, initially you need to know that what are the parameters of what are the features of the discourse. That every discourse has a certain different features. So that now shall we see that what are the features of the report writing? Now, let us see. Now I'd like to share my screen. So dear children, Now, dear children, report writing is a very, very important. Either every day we see that news report. If you see that report, there are different reasons for report writing to present information. The meaning of the it can be a report. Basically, report can be it can be long or short. It is always formal. So the style of vocabulary choice will be depend on who is going to read your report and their level of understanding. These are the things we need to know. So the report, when we write a report, basically these things to be reminded. So report, what is a report? Report means, if you see the definition, give spoken or written account of something that one has observed, heard, done or investigated. So this is the definition of the, according to the dictionary, the definition, the meaning of the report is this one. And now, what is the definition of the report? Now, shall we see the definition? A report is a piece of informative writing that describes a set of actions and analysis. Any result is a response to a specific brief. Basically, when we write a report, this always some information is submitted, and also it describes the some kind of actions or events, whatever happened, that we analyze the result of the incident and in a brief area. So this is the definition. Dear children, you understand, report, when we write report, just we do not write all the way, we do not write each and everything, but we describe the incident or event, anything that has happened or whatever, that the result of the action we submit in a brief. That is a report definition. Now, dear children, now let us see what is the purpose. Why do we write? Okay, now we have seen what is the meaning of the report and what is the definition of the report. But why do we write a report? What is the need of the writing report? Really, do we need what is the purpose of the report? So it, why do we write, means it is the purpose of report, it provides an extensive exploration of the subject. So this is one of the important the purpose of the report. And also, report also helps to communicate within and discuss the problem. This is the major important. Any report, any company or anything, based on the reports only, they will take the decisions. They will discuss the problem. Because suppose if you see that any company problems, so that if there is a report, in the report that everything can be explained, after reading the report, that the decisions can be taken, and the steps what to do, what not to do, that can also, the decisions also can be taken, and also some discuss the problems, and everything, all these things happen by based on the reading the report only. So unless, suppose, simple, very simple thing, dear children, you see that when we go to doctor, just will a doctor advise us to get a scanning or for test, some tests, sent for us a test. But when we get a report, so that we will take it to the doctor. Then based on the report only, the doctor suggests the medicine. So this is the priority of the report, just we need to understand. Anything, any report has the very much importance. So we need to understand the what is the importance of the report. So that is one thing. And also analysis of the data and of issues. Whatever the issues, a particular thing. So all these can be discussed in the report only. So dear children, you understand the purpose. Now we have seen the meaning of the report, meaning of the report, definition of the report, and purpose of the report. Now, dear children, so as 10th class to 9th class students, we need to know that the parameters. When we write a report, basically, we should have some knowledge about that. We should know that parameters. We should know the performance indicators. We should know the features of the report. that as we learned every discourses, there also, here also, we should also learn about the features of the report. Now, dear children, now you see that what is the basically a setup of the report, a formal report arrangement. How it should be? How should be, it should be, report should be written? Dear children, first, whenever, before going, before we start a report, there we need to write to the first one will be headline or title. So in this, what would be cover? So subject of the report. So whatever the subject, dear children, when we write a report, we do not mingle, all the issues. So particular subject we will take, and in the headline only, the subject of the report will be there. And also, there is also in the headline only, who the report for. So when we are writing report it for, there will be purpose, that who we are writing, that for whom we are writing, either it is for the student, either it is for the professionals, either it is for the teachers, doctors, lawyers, for whom, or public or unemployed, or general people, general public, that whom we are writing. So this is the thing we need to understand. Who the report for is the one is one important thing. And also the other one is the date of information. So report, when we write a report, so definitely we should mention the date of information. Dear children, so in the headline, if we cover these subject of the report, who the report for, date of information, these are the major things to be covered in the while we write a report. So this is one thing. Now byline, and this is the other one is byline. Byline is who wrote the report. Important thing is it is also very important. Byline, who wrote the report, the who is writing the report, this is also important. And the other one is the most important facts, lead. The lead is, in the lead, what covers the most important facts. So whenever we write a report, it should not be, there should not, we should not mention any false matter. So important facts to be mentioned. Certainly, we should write only important thing. So in the important facts only, we should mention in the report. So in the report, what is especially why? Why the report? And what? Where? When? Suppose when we write particular matter, so why it is happened, when it is happened, where it is happened, what was happened. So the facts we should mention. If we cover all these things, definitely our report will be good. So lead also, don't forget to write the facts, especially why, what, where, when. So this is the thing. And also later one is body. After completing lead, we should write the body. In the body, information in detail. In the body, definitely we should write, suppose in the beginning just we'll touch the matter, then later information in detail, whatever the information, whatever the incident happened, whatever we are writing, that the information in detail we should write in the body. And also we should also elaborate means in detail, the explain in detail. So don't forget to explain in key. So this is the thing in the body we should cover, information in detail and elaborate the incidents or events. So don't forget to elaborate, don't forget to give information in detail, write in detail. So this is the thing. And later, conclusion. In the conclusion, what shall we write? Dear children, when we write a report, so give scope to think about. In the conclusion, we need to give a small touch, give scope to think about what? So whatever the issue we are writing, whatever the issue we are writing, that in an intelligent conclusion we should be given. Intelligent conclusion means we should give an opportunity to the opportunity to the people to think about it. Whatever the report we are writing, what is, give a scope, a little scope to think about the issue, think about the give a scope to think about the incident. So in the conclusion, these things to be mentioned. So these are the things we should be, these are the basic features of the report. Dear children, suppose if you wanted to write, definitely that everybody will write a report. We'll see that the number of reports, but we need to know that we should understand how many of them are very good reports, that either there are some good reports. So what makes a good report? Suppose if our report wanted to be very good, what should be covered? So number one is a clear logical structure. Dear children, a clear logical structure. So whatever the matter we are writing, that should be very clear, and logical structure should be there. So this is the it makes our report very good. So clear logical structure is one. The next one is accurate. So our report should be accurate. That means what is the facts which we discussed earlier. So when we write a facts, fact events, so definitely that becomes a good report. And the other is impress in the beginning. So with our language, we should impress by forming the sentences, good sentences. We can impress, so that while you write a report, try to impress in the beginning. And next one is avoid colloquial language. So dear children, you need to remember the report always be formal. So avoid colloquial language. That means informal language we should avoid. We should not write the informal language in the report. So definitely always you write the formal language and certainly avoid colloquial language. This is the thing you should understand. And also the most important thing is correct grammar and spelling. Dear children, whatever you write, the sentences, spellings, grammar, and everything is important in the report. Because if we miss the spelling or grammar, if you write all these mistakes, definitely your report will not be good. For our report to be good, so that grammar and spelling. So we should know that at the tense form, what is the structures, and structures, what is the tense, either it is auxiliaries or whatever. That grammar should be correct. So correct grammar, sentences should not be wrong, and structurally it should be correct. And also the spellings also very, very important. Be cautious about the spelling. So very much care about the spelling also, because if the spelling misses, the meaning will be changed. But as English as a magic language, so that if we write any spelling mistake, the meaning will be reported. So that when the meaning, the spelling wrong, the meaning changes. When the meaning changes, your report result is also changes. So that, dear children, you correct grammar and spelling also. You remember if our report to be good. These makes a clear logical structure, accurate, impress in the beginning, avoid colloquial language, correct grammar and spelling make a good report. And apart from that, there is one thing. And some tips for you, dear children. These are the small tips. There are a number of features, but the very, very important features that I am telling you. Now, there are some tips, dear children. Just please remember all these things. Tips, number one tip is write it in simple English. Dear children, when you write a report, any report, just write very simple English. Because when we write a report, the purpose is the others also should understand our report. So if the others do not understand our report, it will not be good. So that you write your report in simple English. This is the one important tip. And the second one is keep the sentences short and to the point. Dear children, sentences always must be very short. So don't write very lengthy sentences in a report. You can also write in in anywhere, but in the report, keep the sentences short and to the point. So these short and to the point, straight to point, whatever the topic, whatever the issue, whatever the event, the straight to be there. So this is the talking, writing straight and short make our report very good. So that this is the one thing, keep the sentences short and to the point, also important. Dear children, the other one is try to communicate. And you always, whatever the sentence that you are writing, that every sentence must be try to communicate with purpose. So you should, that means you are transferring the message, you are transferring the matter, you are transferring the issue. So that the try to communicate, but don't, what is, let us not to be impressed, but our sentences not to impress them in other way, but our sentences to be communicate the matter. So that is one thing. Dear children, the other one is use active voice only. So don't write a passive voice. Active voice means that is, in the passive voice means it is done by so and so, it is completed by so and so. Like you avoid the passive voice, just directly you can use active voice. And the other one is keep an eye on punctuation. Dear children, this is the most important thing. Keep an eye on punctuation. Punctuation is also very, very important. So if there is no punctuation, the readers will read the our report continuously. Continuously, we'll miss the theme, we'll miss the purpose. So that the punctuation, where you know that what is, before writing the report, just you understand the what is the importance of the comma, what is the purpose of the full stop, question mark, inverted commas, like these should be very clear. And punctuation, this is also very, very important. So don't miss the punctuation. Keep an eye on punctuation is important. So dear children, these are the some of the tips for you write our report. Dear children, now let us see model report. Now here I have, I wrote for you model report. So dear children, you understand this one. Please try to see this one and understand. How to write a report, and now here is a model. Write a report on your school sports day celebrations. So dear children, like you will get the question, and now include the following details in your report. So in the report, this is also which we are going to discuss, also important one in the writing a report. The date. So the date, we should not forget the date, venue, the place, welcoming guest, the headmaster's presentation, chief guest message, guest of honor and their message, and special invitees, students role. So this is the thing we need to model we need to include in the model report. Dear children, you see that I wrote here very simple model report. Now report on the sports day. Our question is write a report on your school sports day celebrations. So that we are mentioning all the details. Now you see the heading, like report on the sports day celebrations. Kallur, November 16th. This is a brief report on the school sports day celebrations of ZPHS Chinnagorikondi, held on 13th November 2020 at 5 PM in the school premises. So this is the beginning. Now you see that, dear children. Sri P. Satyanarayan Reddy, the senior teacher of the school, welcomed the gathering. Sri Mark K. Mark, the headmaster of the high school, presided over the function and presented his annual report, highlighting the achievements, limitations, and requirements of the school. Sri Kannan, Sri Kannan, the district collector, was a guest. Sri Satish Kumar, the manager of the local bank, and Sri Sandra Venkatavireya, the MLA of Satupalli, were the guests of honor. The president and the secretary of the local Vidya Committee were special invitees. Many local leaders, parents, and former students attended the function. So, dear children, this is now you see that the chief guest stressed the importance of true player's qualities. His speech was focused on the good qualities of a player. He advised the children not to lose confidence in any case. The MLA advised the students to develop their skills in the games and sports. The local bank manager emphasized the need of game spirit, sincerity, discipline, regular practice to reach our goals. Some students spoke about their experiences in the school. So, dear children, this is the model report, and by observing this one again, and now you see that you should write all these the important details, whatever we discussed. These are the things which are mentioned, that all is covered. The date when you welcoming guests, the headmaster's presentation, chief guest message, guests of honor and their message, special invitees, students. By basing on this, yes, we can develop the report. And this is the thing. Now, dear children, that I would like to give you a home task. As a homework, I am giving you two questions for you. Write a report on 14th November, Children's Day of your school. This is the one question for you, dear children. You're thinking of all these things, thinking of the, all our features of the report. So you can develop, and you practice the one question, write a report on 14th November, children. You can imagine whatever the happened function in your school, you can who the guests are. For this question, who the guests were, who was the chief guest, who are the guest of honors, where is the place, what is the venue, date, and what was their message. And all this we can mention in the first question. And by practicing this, you can be master of the report. And second question, dear children, you witnessed an accident in the evening while going to home. Write a report as an eyewitness. Describe the incident. This is also a very simple question. While you are going to home, just I have seen an incident, that is an accident, which was, I met an accident, somebody met an accident, that you describe the incident in your own words by basing on these all these features of the report. So by thinking of all these reports, just please write down, practice. If you practice 3 or 4, definitely you will become masters of the report writing. Dear children, if you have any doubts, just you can consult your teacher and write all these two questions, reports, and show to your English teacher in your school English teacher. And your English teacher will clarify your doubts. And please write and go to your teacher. As home task, please do them, practice. If you practice, definitely you can be master about report writing. So dear children, this is the thing. This is the thing about the report. Dear children, so now practice well, and I hope you also understood the regarding a report. So now this is the end of the class. Thank you.